Who's out there tonight?
Is it Friday?
No. It's my Friday. It's Wednesday. I was going to say it's Friday date night, but that's not for everybody, just for me, because today's my Friday and I get to sleep in tomorrow. So excited. Hi, Margie. So, who misses Reese's peanut butter cup? Drop me some chocolate. Is there a peanut butter emoji, you guys? Hi, Lori. Is there a peanut butter emoji is what we're talking about. I know there's a peanut one. So peanut butter. So this is just a little snack. Not totally considered a fat bomb, but not totally not considered a fat bomb. So it would be something to give you a little sweetness. I know those are my favorite. So when I saw this recipe, I was like, okay, I'm gonna make this. So I did a little bit of trial run like I always do, and I have some in the fridge. But in the fridge, they were a little bit softer. So I put them in the freezer, and they're going to be in there while I show you how I made them. Super, super easy, which you know that's the way I do it, you guys. So talk to me. Make sure you got your text. If you didn't get a text, do you want a text? And do you want to share this so that we can teach the world how easy and delicious keto is? I would appreciate that. Okay, so let's start. It's so, so easy. I like almond butter, but you can buy regular peanut butter too. The biggest thing with buying things like this, and as you can see, it's gone. I don't eat this except for, sure, Sheila, I'll get you on the text line. I only use this in baking, to be honest. I don't eat it like, because I don't eat toast. So to me, peanut butter goes on toast or French toast, and I don't eat those things. So it's mostly when I make fat bombs or something like this. So it's taken me a long time to go through this. But I did a live on remembering to do the flip. And what that means is reading all the ingredients. And I did it on peanut butter, was one of the things that I talked about. But your ingredients should only say what it is. So this is, my ingredients in this is roasted almonds. That's it. So if your ingredients is more than that when you're buying something like peanut butter or almond butter, then you're, no. So, you know, if you look at your carbs, like I showed an example of an organic peanut butter and then one like this. And the organic peanut butter actually had less carbs, but it had all kinds of stuff in it. Where this has a little higher carbs, but it only is peanuts. So you understand that would make this better, right? It's not always about the carb count. So that's just a little, has nothing to do with how delicious these are, but it's very important that we're looking at that kind of stuff, okay, you guys? All right, so it is 1 cup. I'm breaking this in half since I cooked half of it already. Made. So it's, for me, it's gonna be a half a cup of some kind of peanut butter. I'm using almond, but honestly, you can use whatever. I have a store here called Yolks, and I don't know, you know, everyone's from all over the place, but they have an awesome area where you go and you grind your beans. No, you grind your nuts. And so it's just like coffee. That's why I said beans, because it reminds me of when you go and grind your own coffee. So you go and you pick out whatever nuts you want, cashews, walnuts, almonds, whatever, and you put in this grinder and out comes your peanut butter or your almond butter or your cashew butter, whatever, in a little container, and you bring it home and you put it in your fridge, because you have to put it in the fridge because it's just that product and that's it. So I've been wanting to go there and do a live and show you guys because it's just so cool. All right, so I'm gonna just get all the lumpies out of this real quick. So it just kind of looks like this, you guys. And then it calls for a quarter cup of some kind of sweetener. So I'm gonna put 1/8 cup. Because that is the one thing when you have something that's just roasted almonds, it's not super sweet. Hi! We're sharing the video, number one. We're doing a text line and we're making Reese's peanut butter balls. That's what I call them. But I can't trademark that, so. So anyway, my favorite sweetener is Monk Fruit. This is the brand. You can buy it on Amazon. Costco carries it once in a while, but this, they have an actual website. And my friend, I think it's Teresa, she told me that if you sign up for their email, you'll get a coupon. And so they run great specials and they have coupons. And so that's what I recommend. I usually jump on Amazon and buy it, but if you can get a coupon, right? So we're just mixing that sugar sweetener. I guess it's not sugar, it's sweetener, into this. Because it is kind of bland. That's the one thing with like buying something that's just almond butter. There's not a lot of, it's a little bit bland. So mixing it with a little bit of sweetener to kind of just give you a little bit of, you know, it's not too sweet, but it has a little bit. That's the one thing. You don't want it too sweet. Okay, so we got that all blended. Beth. Oh, you are tagging. I love that. Thank you. So, tell me what everybody's doing tonight. I have the day off tomorrow, and I am thrilled. I'll work a little bit from home, of course, like I always do. I'll be finishing my calendar and things like that, but I get to sleep in, and that's everything. Okay, parchment paper. Now, what we're gonna do, I'm gonna pull these sleeves up so I don't make a mess. Hold on. And we're gonna just make, so I like to get my hands just a little bit wet with something like this. Same when I make fat bombs. It kind of just helps with the rolling and it makes you not stick. See how it's not sticking? So, little trick. When I was younger, we used to always put flour on our hands, right? Back in the day. And then we're just gonna make little balls. See those? And then you can continue to get your hands, you know, a little bit wet. It just helps not to have them stick all over your hands because that peanut butter is kind of sticky. And then you can make them as big or as little as you want. See how I made that one a little bit smaller? What kind of things do you guys wanna see? Hi, Trina. Is there any recipes or somebody asked for Salisbury steak, so I got that on the list. What other things? Someone asked me for lasagna, which is too hard to do for a live. I did get an air fryer though, so I'm not going to do a ton of lives with that because it's not really showing you how to cook, but I will do some. We made some jicama fries in it today, this afternoon for dinner. So I'm going to show you that. Jicama fries was actually on my list. And then I decided to get the air fryer, so we tried that. Hey, girl. How are ya? All right. We're almost done. This is the tedious part of this live. Bear with me. It's going to get better. I promise. No one's talking to me. Come on now. I'll show me some love. Let me know when you share so I can say thank you. I love that you guys all share, but I don't always know who shared or that kind of thing. So let me know. If you're in a good keto group, you know, there's like 1,000 of them or 10,000. Wow. I'm in too many as it is because I can't keep up with all of them. Okay, that's it. Let me rinse my hands really quick. So, can you guys see those okay? Aw, love my air fryer. Yeah, I'm kind of excited about that. It's just something different. And it's, like I said, it won't be something I can use for too many lives, but I definitely will show you some stuff. You guys, tell me what your favorite thing to cook in it is so that I can try that. Now comes the good stuff. Okay, so these ones, they're kind of fell a little bit. I'm gonna roll them a little bit better. But these ones been in the fridge and the freezer. And so you're gonna take your lily chips that look like this, that are chocolate chips that are sweetened. They're a dark chocolate, which is my favorite. And they're sweetened with stevia, so they're totally safe, okay? I made chicken tonight. In your air fryer or just in your life? So I melted some of this chocolate, and that's what the recipe says, and I'll attach the recipe here in a little bit. Cod, oh yeah. Yeah, I'm excited. And you just wanna slowly melt these chips. So like 30 seconds at a time. And you're gonna get this nice consistency. Yeah, that looks perfect. Okay, now we're gonna take, and I'm gonna shape this a little bit better, but they're nice and cold. So the first time I did it, I put it into the fridge. What I would recommend for you guys is the freezer. So throw them in the freezer and then bring them out right when you're ready to roll. Give it some time, you know? So, because this chocolate is a little bit warm, so it's gonna make them want to change their shape as well. Come on. There you go. It's kind of sticky, but we're gonna put it back on the parchment paper, just like so. Look at how good that looks. And then I'll do one more so you guys can get the jits of it. Roll it back up if it flattens out. And you don't even have to roll them up. That's just my thing. But honestly, there's nothing wrong with just drizzling the chocolate over it. You could do that too. I'm just choosing to do it this way. I don't even know what the real directions say. It could have said drizzle it. And there you go. Oh my goodness. Doesn't that look good? Can you guys see it okay? I hope so. All right, I don't want to waste all this chocolate. I want to lick my fingers, but you guys won't like that. Do you like it when I'm up in your business like this? What if you put, oh, for sure. But like I said, you could get this really, really loose and just drizzle it just as easy, but rolling it works, definitely. All right, so let me show you one that I did. So here's one I did, and this one was in the freezer. So it's nice and firm, it's not melted, but you're not gonna wanna leave these out. These are not a candy or a snack that you can leave out. So look at how good that is. So good. It's just like having a Reese's. I'm not even kidding. And smaller the better, because they're rich, super rich. Okay, I took two bites. You know what that means, right? It means I love it. It means I'm not faking. Okay. So peanut butter, almond butter, cashew butter would be really good. Lily chips, and then freezer. Hi, Bonnie. I see you throwing me some love. Thank you. If you would share the video, you guys, I'd really appreciate it. If you want me to text you when I go live, let me know. And then any ideas. Thank you for the air fryer ideas. Those all sound amazing. And like I said, I'm not gonna do a lot of lives with those. I'll do a few to give people who have an air fryer some ideas. But I like more showing you guys how to cook. That's my goal, always, to make it easy, fun, and delicious. So thank you so much. And I will see you tomorrow, and I hope you guys all have a great night. Walmart has sugar-free chocolate chips now. Oh, Lily's are my favorite, but only because I haven't found anything better. What are they sweetened with? Are they sweetened with stevia as well? Could you put in some chocolate? Yes, Rita, you're brilliant. Yes, yes. So you would make it a, what is that? What candy is that that has the crunchy? I guess it's Reese's Crunchy, right? But why couldn't you use nutty peanut butter that doesn't have, you know, it doesn't have sweetener in it, of course, but looks good. You're welcome. All right, you guys. Love you. Thank you. Bye.